Kyle Klingman with Track Wrestling alongside Andy Hamilton for our first ever high school wrestling preview show. It is state championship time. We get into the postseason, and this is fun because there's all kinds of great state championship events that you get to watch on the Track Wrestling platform. But we'll give some context here. We grew up in an era where you pretty much got to see the state championship finals. We grew up in Iowa, and now you get to see state championships all across the country. This is why track wrestling is special, and this is why wrestling has really grown, especially over the last 10 years, and the access, it's really unprecedented.
Yeah, I think 50 state championship events, when you factor in duels and traditional individual tournaments combined on track wrestling, you get to watch them start to finish, and then all the archives are there in the Gold Plus package as well. And this is awesome. As you mentioned, for us, growing up in Iowa, it was Iowa Public Television on Saturday nights, and that was the extent of it. Now we get to watch thousands and thousands of high school state tournament matches.
Here's what you can watch over the weekend, either archived or live. These are the traditional state championships: Alabama, Arizona, Georgia, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maryland, independent schools, Montana, and Nevada, and then state dual championships for Delaware and Oklahoma. And we will stop there with Oklahoma because a couple great teams in Tuttle and Broken Arrow looking to repeat as state dual champions. And when I think of Tuttle, I think of a couple guys that will be at Oklahoma State, a great powerhouse, of course, in college wrestling. Tuttle really has a lot of firepower, and it should be on display this weekend.
Yeah, Luke Serber and Dustin Plott, they've had injuries that have interrupted their senior seasons, but they were top national recruits for Oklahoma State, guys that keyed Oklahoma's freestyle title last summer at the junior duels, and they're part of a couple of key cogs in making Tuttle a powerhouse, a team that ran through this tournament and outscored the opposition by a combined 209-0 count a year ago.
Amazing. And then Broken Arrow has a great team as well. So Oklahoma certainly has the history, and we get to watch the state dual championships. But in Montana, we'll mention that they are going to add women's wrestling to their sanctioned sports for next year. But as we focus on this year, Montana has an interesting storyline because there's two guys going for four state championships, but only one will come out with a four-time state championship. Let's dig into what that storyline is all about.
Yeah, so on the top side of the bracket at 126 pounds, Jake Bibler is a senior going for his fourth title. On the bottom side of the bracket, Cooper Birdwell, a junior in pursuit of his third title. Only one of those guys is going to emerge. So looking forward to a potential battle between those two. There's a lot of talk out in Montana about how that one might shake out. So eager to potentially see it Saturday night.
Love the storylines that coming out of Alabama. Here's a tough guy at 120 pounds, number 10, Corey Land. He was on a Greco-Roman cadet world team, which was on the track wrestling platform. He is going for a state championship, his second state title, and a guy that you just want to focus on because he's a guy that you probably don't get to see Alabama that much, but you get to see him on the platform.
Yeah, and we're seeing more and more top-level talents coming out of the Southeast region. We'll talk about Georgia here later in the show, but Alabama as well. Corey Land, 99-0 for his career, made a cadet Greco World team this past summer, also was in the cadet freestyle finals as well. So guy that has helped put Alabama on the map a little bit more from the high school wrestling front, somebody that people across the country are paying attention to. And certainly, as I mentioned, we've seen more and more guys coming out of there. Brandon Womack at Cornell, an All-American, a guy who won 422 matches in his high school career in Alabama. A lot of people wonder how that's possible, but Alabama, they wrestle upwards. Some kids down there are going to wrestle upwards of 80 matches in a high school season, and we see some pretty gaudy records when they're done.
Do you think the Iowa Hawkeyes are excited about this guy, Jesse Ibarra, number three at 132 pounds, going for his third state championship in Arizona? And when you watch the Hawkeyes, they're very passionate fans, but this is why you can watch them in high school and then say, I know why Iowa recruited this guy. And Ibarra is certainly one of those guys. He is a dynamic wrestler.
Yeah, we just mentioned Corey Land being in the Akron finals, the cadet freestyle finals last year. Jesse Ibarra was there as well. He was a runner-up in Akron, a guy who comes in with big-time credentials, a Fargo title to his resume, and a pair of Arizona State titles as well. He lost in last year's finals, battled some injuries down the stretch, and was a runner-up a year ago, but won titles as a freshman and sophomore. The Hawkeyes are getting a good one there.
And then Georgia's come on the scene. There's some great storylines out of Georgia, Drew Eller being one of those, and you can explain why Drew Eller has a special story.
Yeah, so Drew Eller, kid who was diagnosed with cancer, I think when he was 3 years old, and then overcame that a couple years later, started getting on the mat a little bit, and here he is coming into his final career, or final tournament of his high school career, undefeated, 200-plus wins, zero losses, one of the nationally ranked guys coming out of Georgia. There's about, I think, seven or eight nationally ranked guys that we have in the track wrestling high school rankings, including Drew Eller, who's ranked number 18. And then three guys from Woodland of Cartersville that have been in the national rankings this year as well. Caleb Henson, one of those guys at 145 pounds. And then another guy, Matthew Singleton at 152, the highest ranked guy in Georgia right now in our rankings, comes in at number five. Had a tremendous tournament out at the Doc Buchanan where he really skyrocketed up the national rankings. But he's a guy who's been in the Fargo finals as well in both styles.
All kinds of good stuff on the Track Wrestling platform. This is our first show, but we're going to keep you engaged in all of the things happening across the country. We'll give you all the highlights. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.